Braverman. What is it about my neck?
80-pound
Alcatraz. Alcatraz, right. The rhyme of the ancient Alcatraz. This is an albatross. Can I throw it out?
You can throw it out.
It's lose effective. This albatross, yeah.
Come on in, you guys.
Having shoulder, bought 20 shoulder, seconds.
Shoulder. Semicircle.
Shoulder it in.
Zoom over here.
Let's do the amoeba.
All right, can I get Kaylee Cleary? Oh, no. Okay. If you do not know how to ask the right question, you discover nothing. W. Edwards. Yeah, I've been getting into some dimming. Thanks, Seth. There's some great stuff out there. Some coming up here. Looks like a win today, so move on before some. Let's not oversell, Brett. Yeah, I'm with you. Believe me. Yeah, so looks like all of Bread and Butter West Side is
in the red. Customs should be in the red. Where did I let go?
It's also in the red. So if you're anywhere not in one of those areas, not working on something that's got to go today, perhaps see if you can help out in those areas.
I could use relief on the saw from anyone, whoever gets time.
I think that'll be me or Ben.
Well, that'd be great. Thanks.
We'll talk after lunch.
Thank you.
I could do wiring.
So this video was sent in.
Hey, you guys knocked it out of the park. Best online order I've ever had in my life. Yeah, customer service amazing, packaging, shipping, everything was just perfect. The construction, well done, you guys, keep it up. I'd love to come visit you sometime. See you soon.
Woo.
Look at him. Cool. He's smart. Wow, pretty cool stuff. That's cool.
That was Mike.
It was an online order. Oh my gosh, very nice.
He needs lots of pedestals.
Is that Deming?
He needs a lot.
Is that Deming?
He needs a ton of pedestals.
It is Deming.
Was that really Deming?
No. That's Deming's great grandson. He's a sculptor.
Hi guys, Tony here. So I'm just, please make an improvement on how to detail black laminate pedestals, like premium pedestals. One of the biggest problems we've been having is a lot of ghosting all the way around here. And that's because we've been doing this like a normal pedestals, like well, the way we detail it. But the problem with this, these black laminate pedestals, they're like really tricky and really picky. So one thing that we decide to do is, so as soon as you detail these and it's ready to peel, instead of just peel the tape and just clean the glue or whatever needs to be clean, what we're gonna do, we're gonna start doing now, we're gonna peel everything now. So. Right here is nothing to worry about. So don't assume that you need to spray it and you need to clean it or you need to put some vinegar all over so you clean it. So if it's nothing here, don't do anything. Okay? So over here we got glue. So if everywhere you got glue, all you have to just put some vinegar on and let it soak. All these edges we got glue. Okay, so let it soak. Make it into little glue. So like I said, don't spread the whole side. Just one minute. And if it's just dirty, all you have to do is just use a dry rag to clean the dust. Let's say, no wet, no nothing, just dry. Okay? So I got my stuff. We got the time. Got the little soap for a while. You start to touch and colors. So that's something I have to do. Okay? So this is a little bit better than trying to just use a wet rag and just kind of rub it off, try to take that off. Just let it soak. And then it's a little bit of 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 a little bit nice to have a one minute. Every now, if you go right, you should be good. So this is the way, which side to go now. All the guys giving up, one of you, three, two, three damage. Especially one, I don't know where from. I think you guys in any.
Quick summary, Tony. The quick clarification is only dissolve the glue with a minimal amount of solvent. Is that correct?
Vinegar.
Vinegar, right. That's the solvent for glue. Yes.
And pre-peel.
And what is the next takeaway from that?
So you just, after it's nice and soft, you use another wet rag with vinegar to kind of wipe them off. And a dry one behind us, so you just dry that thing.
Chase it right
yes,
off.
Right after.
Got it. And don't smear dissolved vinegar water over the whole damn thing.
Yeah, because as we know, when you say detail, you feel like if you peel the tape, you need to clean the whole thing. So I see it in the past, they're spraying it. It's like I told these guys, if it's nothing there, just use a dry rack and clean it if it's dust. That's it.
So what we actually experienced from this project, Genchi, this kids, is that when we peeled this away, I thought we were having a ghosting problem from the glue, and it's actually, this is a burnishing and a distribution of crap problem, and this is as virgin as it ever be. So the idea is start off and don't put any more crap onto it or spread it around, essentially. Yeah. The management of fingerprints and glue that's dissolved and black wax and stuff, right? That's kind of where our problems are of our own making in a way.
Yeah.
So
this is for the premium?
The premium at the moment.
And then I couldn't tell in the beginning of the video, you still did the sanding and the ink and the wax?
Yes,
the
everything is normal.
Okay.
Yeah, all the stuff is the same.
Dye and crayon.
And Zane is not here, but at this moment, if you are here, I don't see you. But there is a group, and I'd like to continue with this experiment, is as you do at least blacks, wear gloves throughout the whole process to see if we can reduce the amount of hand smudges that get transferred. And it's reducing one variable.
Yeah.
And I know some of us, we sort of end up peeling off gloves if we're easily irritated or frustrated. So try to get in the habit of using the surgical gloves and see if that helps at least reduce the cleaning time. One by one component. Steve.
I know we're mostly out of large of those gloves. There's a stack right here on the cart by Wendy. If
cool.
You guys
thank
really
you.
Needing
you
some.
Got more coming in, right?
Yeah.
Good, thank you. Hey guys, real quick. We're gonna store some lengths of nice hardwood in this little cubby here because the customs area periodically needs some legitimate good finished hardwood. So that's where it's gonna be located for now. And probably the drop will end up getting closer to the wire. Maybe even mix it down here and I think that'll be okay. But it's a good location to go to for that type of thing. Maybe we'll get some other shelves in here with other moldings since this floor space is already condemned. Thank you.
Yeah, please don't S it. Thank you. That's a storage cart. It'll probably have some other things tucked in there too.
Oh, I'm back. I have a switch down here, actually a valve. All I do is turn it on. It's noise. What it does is it circulates a lot of the sawdust inside, and it looks like a giant snowstorm in there. So I also added an extra section here of 4 inches. So as it rotates through there, it just sucks it all in, and I never opened up the cabinet door until it's 9 degrees all here.
What was the problem that made you do this?
We would always have to open up the cabinet door, and when we open it up, it would be completely filled with sawdust.
That'll turn it.
The sawdust would bypass the little tube that would suck all the stuff down.
Awesome.
So
way to go.
All three machines, this saw, the other saw is set up that way, and my last saw is the saw that I have to run here to, and we're good. We don't have to take the extra time to dig it all out and run around with the portable vacuum cleaner to suck it out.
Awesome, man. Thanks.
Thanks, guys.
That's a huge improvement.
We're going to do this tomorrow. Okay. It's a little longer.
All right.
1 minute with Greg.
I got a 39 second minute. I'll get back to a minute.
Yeah, yeah.
We're having problems with the... a lot of problems that we maybe don't realize could be solved through a Kaizen with a few people. So one of the ones is bulbs. So you get what you tolerate. So don't tolerate stupid stuff like every fifth bulb socket doesn't work and it's okay to get bugged.
Yeah.
And a lot of us, I think, you know, there's a certain amount of habituation and complacency that can happen in the workplace. Like, that one sucks, I'll get another one. It's like, nah, that really sucks times a year. Times all the people who do it. So we're dealing with the sockets right now. So at the moment, a deeper inspection into this, I'm not going to play the video, but anyone who's doing light bulb sockets, we can crank more aggressively on it, but we got to get away from these party bulbs. The quality is below the standard that we need for the electronics that we put together. So a lot goes in it, and then you put a 50-cent part in on a $1,200 product,
and we pay another $500 to $1,000 in escapes and crap and rework. So
yep.
The point being is I'd love to see the use of the Gemba board come back online. I did a solo walk. I'm going to do a Gemba meeting with three people after this meeting. It's been a real challenge for all of us. We got too much in the weeds. Rob and I have been amazed how often we forget, even though we're committed to each other to do it, that it's gotten away from us. So that is a powerful tool to use, and my intention is to absolutely have some good material. So when you have a problem, put it on the board. That's how you deal with it. Plus, it can help you step one step away from just being frustrated and going on and kind of carrying that burden or resentment with you.
Yeah. If you see someone stressing, frustrated, dealing with stupid waste, you can tell that they're being bugged by something. Just ask them, is that on the board yet, or can I put that on the board for you? Maybe we can start helping each other fill those boards up. When we were doing it regularly, those things would fill up every week.
It's a very powerful tool. It's just a matter of whether you want to use it or not.
Yeah, it's one of the feedback loops for improvement. So we need, if no problem is a problem.
It's part of the C of PDCA.
Yeah, what's the piece of it really in terms of psychology that's probably got the most positive impact if we use it diligently? Anybody have an opinion on that?
Like the guys throwing fish at Pike Place, they, as a team, they say we have bad moments, not bad days. So they put to rest the bad moment, they move on with their day. It's an opportunity for us to shelve it and get it out there, get it exposed, and then move on knowing that something's going to happen. There'll be some retribution in the future.
I think the idea is maybe we give our problem a timeout. Hey, you, timeout. I'll catch up with you later. Go sit in your room. And then we come back when everyone's calmed down and talk to our sister.
Yeah.
Tell her we love her and work it out, even if we don't feel it.
Excellent. Thank you, Greg.
Minute and a half.
I have one more thing before we do that.
One more thing.
Okay, and then
two more things.
We have emergency contacts for everybody. They are on the S drive, and they are printed out. When we're all here, please go to a supervisor, John, or Dallas, or Seth, or anybody else who has access to the S drive would be good too. If you're here in the weekend, or you know you're here late at night and you're by yourself, and one of your coworkers gets hurt, obviously deal with the situation. But if you need their contact information, it's under Wendy's phone. We want to keep it confidential, but there is a printed copy under Wendy's phone if you absolutely need it.
Cool.
Thanks, Amy.
Great.
Thank you.
So. Oh, we have a guest and also a new face.
Yes, please. Jamie Parker.
Where's she going?
Yeah.
Jamie and I ran into each other in an unmarked hallway in Pittsburgh.
I think you were stalking me.
Yeah, I was kind of stalking her. It was pretty funny. So she got wrapped into my talk. But we were both talking about what we've done with our organizations. Tell us your story real quick.
Sure, yeah. So I work with FedEx Office, which is the Kinko side of FedEx, so think printing. We have 18 locations around the country that do the high-volume commercial printing. And we practice Lean to help us create more value for our customers and also have an impact on the lives of the people that we serve each day. But it has been a tough, tough journey. In fact, I can tell you that the way we started was by making a kit of cut vinyl labels and sending a PowerPoint deck and saying, hey, go 5S your workplace. Here's what it needs to look like. Here's all the labels you need. Make it look like this. And then when your manager comes in, we're going to start auditing compliance. So as you can imagine, it didn't quite hit on either the respect for people piece of Lean, or even the continuous improvement piece, or the engagement of everybody in improving their work rather than being top down. So it's been a tough, tough journey, but it's been fun, and we get better as we go, right? So far from perfect, but we continue to get better. And I just wanted to come up and see Greg's shop. I live down in Littleton, so I'm local, and wanted to see what you guys are up to.
Nice.
Thanks for making
cool, thanks.
Yeah.
What will be your obvious takeaway from your visit here?
See anything jump out at you?
What's an outlier for you?
So,
good or bad?
Yeah. So I think that there are two things that I really want to take away. The first is I like how immediate the feedback was. I think one of those videos that you did like was today,
mm-hmm.
right? And so the fact that, hey, here was something that happened, we were able to get it communicated and shared to everybody so quickly, that doesn't happen as often in our organization. I think we have a little bit of a lag. So I think that was a key takeaway. And then the other piece that I want to go back and look and say is, do the people who are working the floor, do they know what they need to get done today? Why? What is this? You know, like, is there some purpose to it? But also, do I know what I need to get done? Do I know if I'm behind or not? Because I think that's something that's probably a shared opportunity between your group and our group, is figuring out how to do that.
Yeah. Clear roadmap. Thanks, Jamie.
All right, now's the time for shout-outs. Show some gratitude.
Steven.
Wendy and Lori for dressing up.
Yeah. Yay! Yay! Yay!
Thought about it.
Yeah.
Second and third.
Thank you.
Four.
You're good.
Bob and Tony for knowledge sharing and positivity. Just helped me with Blue Up, and just every question I had, they answer it.
Who was that? I'm sorry.
Rob and Dallas. Rob and Tony, sorry.
Mark, what do you got?
I just wanted to shout out whoever brought that pecan pie in yesterday.
Here.
Who
did?
Mark Lunt.
Oh.
Thank you, Mark. Pecan.
Thank you, Mark.
Pecan.
Yeah.
Did he bake it?
No.
Went to a wedding and brought it back with him.
Oh. Rob. Did they know Rob?
I got a shout out, Sean, again, for pretty much the complete opposite, yes. For just learning really quickly and asking a lot of questions, asking the right questions.
Thanks.
Doing great. And also, I got to shout him out for yesterday. Everybody. And this isn't an anti-shout-out to everybody else, but most people went home, and he stayed and cleaned up the west side.
Oh, yeah,
that was
nice.
Really cool.
Yeah.
So instead of saying, hey, is there anything I can do to help you while I'm leaving, he actually stayed?
Yeah, he stayed, and he cleaned up after everybody had left.
Thank
so
you.
So that was cool.
Shout Rob out for patient teaching of Sean. I heard about it through the grapevine. Someone witnessed it.
Marvin Dan.
Yeah, so just making it safe. Real important.
Oh yeah, and we do have a new face.
I'm Jacob.
Hi, Jacob.
I'm going to school at Front Range.
And you are a good friend of Zane's, right? Yeah. Grew up together?
Yep.
Okay. Paul Zane?
No.
Not
Zane.
Z1.
How many Zanes can there be?
Two.
All of two. Cool. Thanks for coming by. What are you majoring in?
Engineering.
Cool. What form of engineering?
Chemical
engineering. Okay, cool.
Good job.
You got two of them in the house. Cool. Thanks for coming by, helping us out.
Yes.
All right. Anyone else?
Nope. Then let's
take it easy.